Hello, this is Mahesh Ravi and I'm back with a new video. Today we're going to look at what exactly is a LOTI file and how to apply that in your website. So LOTI files are basically animated files. The main advantage of LOTI file is that it's really compatible with any platform that you're using. Another thing is that the file size of it is very, very, very less. So if you actually look at this, website. So I'm using a website called lotifiles.com, which is a huge repository of LOTI files. But just try and understand why a LOTI file is really useful when it comes to designing a website or maybe creating a prototype. So let's try and understand what is a LOTI file, right? So a LOTI file is an animated JavaScript object notation file. So it's the extension of a LOTI animation file is going to be JSON. So what we will be looking at is in this video are two things: how to use a LOTI file in a simple website using the Wix platform, and how to use LOTI in an advanced interactive way using Webflow. So we'll be looking at two platforms here. One is Wix for a non-interactive display of a LOTI animation, and Webflow for an advanced interactive version of a LOTI animation. So let's take a look into that. So I'm going to go to LOTI file to find a file that we can download and use it for this exercise. You can also create it by yourself. We'll do another tutorial on that soon. But for this exercise, I'm going to take an animation that I... So you can go to LOTI files. You can see that there are several categories in here. There is a popular category. And you can see that there are tons of them which are available for you to use for free. So we can come down and I'm going to use maybe, right. Let's choose one. This actually seems pretty cool. So I'm going to take that. Okay. Let's open this up. And there are a couple of options that you can do here itself. You can download that to a GIF file that you can download and use it. You can download it as a JSON file, right? And you can also do some corrections here. You can change the animation speed. So if you click on this, the speed of the animation is going to go up. The speed of the animation is going to go up. You can change the background color. So if you want it to be red. So whatever code that you're, or whatever color code that you're using it in your design, you can do that, right? So if you leave it this, it is going to create a transparent background. So we can leave it at transparent background. So it is not going to have any background information in here. So let's come down and you can use this animation in an HTML website, or you can use this in Webflow. There are two options which are available right now. These are the two options we'll be using it. There are other ways that you use it by including this in an Apple application or an Android application. So we are going to start with the HTML version of this. So just click on HTML. It's going to open up a different page which says embed LOTI animations on your website. So we're going to see a couple of options in here, right? You can see the animation preview and you can see the code which is generated. This is what we actually need. But before that, we need to customize a few things. We need the animation to be auto-playing. We don't need the controls to be visible, so we can turn it off. Right. We can set it to loop, and this is actually good to go. We are good to go. And we can also change the size here, but we can do that later as well. The background color is transparent. Everything is actually looking good. So we can come here. We can copy the code. So right now the code is copied. Now we need to embed this into a website. So to do that, the first option that we're going to do is we're going to go to a simple HTML website. So let's go to Wix.com. Let's create a new site. So we are here in a blank Wix website right now, right? We are going to add the LOTI animation that we just created, right? We copied it already. So the information, the code is actually in our clipboard. So we need to put it here. So to do that, we need to go to add and we need to go to embed. Right in here, you can see an HTML frame. You click on that and the HTML frame is added right here. So click on the enter code section and paste our code and apply it. And it's going to load the LOTI animation into our website. We can see that it's loaded right now. you can scale it up, right? So it is scaled, it's coming here. So this is what I said. This is how you incorporate a LOTI animation into your simple website, but this is the beauty of it, right? So you can just go to code and you can say that you need your size of this animation needs to be bigger. So you can just change it here. So I'm gonna change this to 600 into 600 and click update. The size of the animation has changed. You just have to increase the frame so to make the whole animation visible, and this is lossless. The quality still remains the same. Even if we resized it, it looks the same, right? So this is one thing that you can do with it, and it's basically transparent. So if you change the page background color to any color that you want, right, it's gonna work seamlessly there. So this is how you can add it to your website, right? But as I was saying, a lot of interactivity is not possible here without editing too much of code, which can be slightly difficult for most of us designers, because we are not hardcore coders, right? So it will be easier for us if you use a platform like Webflow, which actually does visual coding, right? So we'll try the same experiment in Webflow and see how we can add some interactivity into the design, right? So let's go back to the LOTI animations. So we are here in the animation page right now, and let's look for an animation that we can use. So I'm gonna look for some more options here. It's pretty good, right? So in this scenario, what I'm gonna do is, rather than just downloading an HTML or copying the code, we can download the JSON file. So I'm gonna click here and download the JSON file right into our computer. This JSON file, which I told you earlier, it's a JavaScript object notation file. This is what we'll be using in Webflow to create some advanced interactions, right? So we are gonna go to Webflow. Let's go to Webflow. So this is how Webflow is gonna look. Right, it is a visual coding platform, so you can see that there are a couple of options here. So if you are a coder, you might be familiar with all these terms, right? Sections, containers, div block, all that stuff. So I'll do a detailed tutorial on Webflow later, but for this exercise I just want to add the LOTI animation that we just added and give some interaction to it. But before doing that, let's try and add some elements into it. So I'm gonna just go and add a section here, and I'm gonna add a container inside that section, and I'm gonna add a text element that we can use. So let's go here, add a heading. So we have a heading here, and I'm gonna add a little bit of paragraph, and below that I'm gonna add a button also. So very basic setup here. Now in between this, I need to add an animation which behaves with our website, the way that user interacts with the website. So we're gonna do that. So let's try doing that, okay? Let's go to this button where you keep your assets. So I'm gonna click upload, and we already downloaded the animation LOTI file. Open that. So it will be uploaded to your asset panel. You can see a preview also. You can just drag and drop it where you basically want it. So right now it appears here, right? And this is good to go, right? We are good to go. So now if you click on the preview button, you can see that the animation is starting. It's starting just like that and stopping after one play. But we have to actually give some advanced interaction to this, right? I want the animation to start when a user starts to scroll down this page, right? That's what I want to do. So to do that, I'm going to select the LOTI animation and go to interactions, and we can add a page trigger. So click here and add while page is scrolling. So while page is scrolling, what should happen? So you're going to click on while page is scrolling, and what is the action that should take place when you're on scroll? So you can select an action from here. I'm going to select play scroll animation. We just selected that. Now we can see that there is no scroll animation in here. You can just click here and you can add LOTI from here, right? So the LOTI animation file is added here. You can see that This is basically the page height, right? So this is when we are at the top of the page, Loti animation is here, and we are at the bottom of the page, the Loti animation is also here. But we have to actually define that at 0% of the page, the Loti animation is at what? So we can just move it here. So it is at 0%, this is at frame 0 of the animation, but at 100%, this is at frame 93, let's keep it at 93 of the animation, right? So once we have done that, click on done and let's preview it. Now nothing is happening, but the moment we scroll down, we can see that the animation is happening. It's a pretty interesting interaction that we can do. So I showed you two ways to integrate Loti into your website. One is as an HTML embed, where not much of interaction is possible, especially when you're using in a platform like Wix. But if you're actually doing it on Webflow or an advanced CMS platform, you can definitely add some interactions like this into a JSON file, right? So I hope this was useful. Try it out, and I'll be doing a detailed tutorial on Webflow shortly. Thank you for watching. Subscribe and share the videos. Thank you. Take care. Bye.